I found love in you. And I've learned to love me too. Never have I felt that I could be all that you see. It's like our hearts have intertwined into the perfect harmony. This is why I love you. Ooh, this is why I love you. Because you love me. You love me. This is why I love you. Ooh, this is why I love you. Because you love me. I found love in you. And no other love will do. Every moment that you smile chases all the pain away. Forever and a while, in my heart is where you'll stay. This is why I love you. Ooh, this is why I love you. Because you love me. You love me. This is why I love you. Oh, this is why I love you. Because you love me. Stars have all aligned, and right now is the perfect time to say, I love you, 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 I do. This is why I love you. This is why I love you.
put your hands together. Friends, loved ones too. We're gathered here today in the sight of God, the Father, the Holy Spirit, His Son, Jesus Christ, to bear witness of the decision that this couple have made to solemnize their wedding vows before the Lord. God have given us an example, and He have given us strict direction in regards to the commitment that one should have to another. He did not leave us alone. But I want to say today to each and every one of you, thank you for coming. We are here today to celebrate with Carmen and Milton, and to have their marriage committed to the Lord. And we all have a part to play in this. You are here as a witness today to bear with what the Lord said would come to pass. And this is all about making ready for the return of the Lord. You are in a fellowship and a family, a community of loved ones to bless you and to be here with you, to strengthen, to remind you of your commitment. And we pray that what will be a long life, a lifelong happiness together will be yours. Before we do this celebration, we would like to bow our heads in prayer at this time, and I would like to invite Deacon Bradwell White, who will pray this prayer at this time.
Lord God Almighty, creator of this heaven and earth, thank you for the gift of marriage, for all the joy and love that it brings us. We thank you for Milton and Carmen. Thank you that you have brought them together this special day, and that you have held them safely in your hands. We pray that you will richly bless them as they exchange their vows and their wedding ring. And from this day forward, they would walk hand in hand in everything that they do and destined for them. Give them our hearts and belonging to you now. In Jesus' name we pray.
Let more transcend it.
Slowly we meet you in there before.
Grant them the peace.
not left alone, Carmen and Milton. You are left with the guidance of the Holy Scriptures. Not long from now, the service will be over. The lights will be off and all the well-wishers will return home. And the spotlight will be left on you both alone. Yes. That means God has not left you and throw you out in the middle of nowhere to fend for your own self. But He has provided for us His guidance through the Holy Spirit. Amen. And through His scriptures. If at any time you find yourself at a point that you needed some guidance, first run to the scriptures. Amen. It is there.
Amen.
You will find hope, you will find comfort, you will find direction. Paul in his writings, according to 1 Corinthians chapter 13, he says, love is patient and love is kind. Love is not jealous, it is not boastful. Love is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable. It is not resentful. It does not rejoice in wrong, but it rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hope all things, endure all things. Love never fails. And I'll add, there is no law that can throw you in jail because you express your love one to another. I believe that it is in such a union that you come together to be joined together in holy matrimony. I believe it is in this holy union and in this agreement that you have come together to be joined together in holy matrimony. Who gave this woman to be wed?
I do.
Thank you very much. Today, dear friends, we are gathered to witness the marriage of Carmen and Milton. And I charge you as the congregation, if there be anyone here today with any just reason why these two should not join together in holy matrimony, will you please speak now or forever hold your peace? I think it's clear.
Grow forever.
I see a special smile in the bride and the groom's face at this time. Amen. I charge you both before God and these witnesses today that if either of you know any just cause why you should not be joined together, speak now or forever hold your peace. Is it really silent? That means we can go ahead.
Yes, please.
Amen. Amen. Do you, Mr. Milton Clare, take this woman to be your lawful wedding wife? We're not finished. To have and to hold, to love and to cherish in sickness and in health. For better, for worse, until death you both shall part. Now it's your turn, sir.
Yes, you do. Yes, you
amen.
Do. Yes, you
amen.
Do.
Amen.
Yes,
you're asking for silence as the bridal party make their decision at this time. Thank you. Carmen, do you take this man, Mr. Milton Clare, to be your lawful wedding husband, to have and to hold, to love and to cherish in sicknesses and in health? Until death you both shall part.
I do.
I do.
Thank the Lord.
Loud and clear. Amen. You both have convinced me, as we meet in counseling, that you're entering into this union because of love. And that's the reason. And the number one reason for you both making this decision. I pray that God will strengthen, grant you the peace and the courage that is needed as you take your new journey. He will be your guide.
Hallelujah.
Do we have a ring? Let us bow our heads in prayer. Our Father and our God, we bow before you today. We thank you for this wonderful privilege that we can come before you to present to you this couple. Lord, they have presented the symbol of love as a ring to place on the fingers of their loved ones. I ask that you will grant your blessings today. You will bless this ring that as they wear it, Father, it will remind them of your commitment to us, that you loved us unconditionally and will never leave us nor forsake us. May they use you as an example and turn to you as their guide, even in times of discouragement. Grant your blessings, we ask, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Mr. Milton, would you at this time take the ring and place it on the fourth finger, you know which one.
Okay.
Uh-huh. Don't hurt her now.
I won't.
And as you do that, I want you to say after me and look her straight in the eye. We don't want you to focus on anyone else but her right now. I, Milton Clare. Place on your finger.
This ring.
As a symbol of my love.
And faith.
To you. Amen. Carmen, there's a ring left here, and I'm sure you know what you're going to do with it. Thank you. And you will say after me, I, Carmen Thompson.
I, Carmen Thompson,
do give to you this ring.
Do give to you this ring
as a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love
and commitment to you.
And commitment to you
as my lifelong.
As my lifelong commitment. Commitment.
Amen.
Amen.
We're going to ask you to kneel, and we're going to be praying for you both at this time.
Father, we come to you, who is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that we can ask or even think. Lord, today we bring before you your son Milton and your daughter Carmen. We are excited, Lord, to witness the beginning of their new journey and the beginning of a new chapter in their lives. The Bible says, for this cause shall a man leave his mother and his father, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they both shall be one flesh. And so, Lord, today we commit this couple to you. We commit Carmen and Milton into your hands. And we ask, Lord, that you will be their mentor from this day forward, that you will mentor them on this journey. Lord, we ask that you will protect them. Lord, we ask that you will guide them. Lord, we ask that you will lead them and you will direct every movement in their lives. We pray for a special blessing upon them today.
Yes.
Lord, we ask that you will multiply them in every way and in every sense of the word. We pray for multiplication in their finances. We pray that you will multiply their joy.
Yes.
We pray you will multiply the love that they have for each other.
Yes, Lord.
And Lord, above all, you will multiply the love that they have for you.
Yes.
Father God, we pray that you will grant them mercies, that you will help them to grow in love and in unity. And we ask, mighty God, that as they commit themselves together today, they will be committed for the rest of their lives to themselves, to their families, and to you. Lord, we ask that you will seal this union. We ask that you will prosper them, Lord. We ask that a double portion of your blessings and your presence will be with them every step of the way. And as we commit them to you and as we seal this marriage, Lord, we are doing it in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit.
As much as you have agreed together to enter into holy rite of wedlock, and have given and received a ring in token and in pledge of your love and loyalty to one another, in the sight of God and all these witnesses, it is my pleasure to pronounce you as man and wife, husband and wife. By the gift that is given to me as a minister of the gospel by God and by the state of Florida, I now pronounce you as husband and wife. Mr. Milton is eagerly waiting for me to give him the key. Sir, I want to ask for you at this time. We have made it so easy that you don't even have a veil to remove. So we're going to ask you at this time if you would salute your bride with a kiss. I would like to say congratulations, Mr. Clare, for the bold move that you have made and the decision to take this woman to be your lifetime partner. I want you to know my prayers are here for you, and my support in any way possible. Look around. Look at the crowd. Look from corner to corner. Look at the many people that have come to join in celebrating your joys today. I want to say congratulations. These are supporters that you can call on at any time you are in need of help. Amen. Mrs. Claire,
yeah.
You know. You know that you are greatly loved and cared for, and at any time we are here to give you the support that is needed. This is a new journey for both of you. This is a journey that you are going to tread that nobody have ever tread before. What does that mean? It means that you may have to take your cutlass and cut some bushes that are in the path to give you a clear and a safe path together to travel. Because these are journeys that nobody have tread before. God promised that He's going to be there with you and to help you along the way. Somebody just want to see Mr. Clear salute his bride.
One more time.
One more time. Woo-hoo! And it's not over as yet. I'm going to ask you at this time to face each other. Face each other, and Mr. Clear, if you would, take your bride's hand and turn them palms up. Look at these hands for what blessings they are to you. Bride, I would like to ask you to take his hands, your hands below and his above, and look at those hands for what blessings they are to you. These are the hands that are of your best friend. They are strong, they are vibrant with love. These hands which are resting in yours on this your wedding day are the hands of the one who promised to love you for all the remaining days of his life. These hands which will work long hours alongside you and will build your future as you laugh and cry together. As you share your innermost secrets and dreams, these are the hands that will work long hours for you, and them which will passionately love and cherish you throughout the years. Look at those hands. Those are the hands that will wipe away tears of sorrow and tears of joy from your eyes. These are the hands which will tenderly lift your chin and brush your cheek as they raise your face to look into his eyes that will be lifted with passion for none but you. Mr. Clare, I'm going to ask you to place your hands below and look at her hands for the blessings they are to you. Mr. Clear, these hands are the hands of your best friend, which are holding yours on this your wedding day. She has pledged her love and her commitment to you for the days all the days of her life. These are the hands which will hold you tight as you struggle through difficult times. These are the hands which will comfort you when you are sick and will console you when you grieve. These are the hands which will passionately love and cherish you through all the years for a lifetime of happiness. Will the congregation stand with me one more time and let us bow in prayer. Our Father and our God, we are in your presence one more time to ask of your coverage, protection, direction, and guidance, provision, and everything that is necessary on their new journey. Father, we know today that this event is all about preparing two people for your return. It serves as a reminder of those of us who are still wondering what to do and what decision to take. We ask, O God, that you, through your divine will, you have a way of working into the lives of individuals and to get our attention. We ask for your blessings today upon this couple. May the peace of God that passeth all understanding keep your mind and hearts in one. May the Lord of heaven richly bless and sanctify you for his return.
You may be seated at this time while we'll go.
Put your hands together and welcome Mr. and Mrs. Taylor.
Thank you very much. It is my pleasure to present to you. It is my pleasure to present to you this copy of your certificate. And it is always said to give it to who?
A woman.
You know why? Because they are very careful when they are in love. So I would take it as a pleasure in presenting this to you, Madam Claire. Mr. Milton, I give to you the privilege, one more time, legally, to salute your bride at this time. God bless you.
Thank you.
God keep you. May the light of his countenance rest upon you and give you peace from God the Father. Go in the name of the Lord. God bless you.
All right, hold up here. boy and I will hold on, move so on, I will hold on.
Lord God, we just want to thank you that we are about to receive of your blessings. We pray that you'd bless the food and sanctify it, that it might be of good use to our bodies. Bless this family gathering, I pray, dear God, and keep us safe. for the rest of the evening, and for those who will be returning home to their different places of abode, I pray that you'll grant them guidance and protection. In Jesus' name we pray.
Oh, but somehow you never got your turn. My eyes would fill with water inside, I burn. Oh, yes, I did.
This time. Right foot, let's start. Left foot, let's start. Cha-cha now, y'all. Last time to get funky. To the right now. To the left. Take it back now, y'all. One hop this time. One hop this time. Right foot, two stumps. Left foot, two stumps. Slide to the left. Slide to the right. Crisscross. Crisscross. Cha-cha, real smooth. Let's go to work. To the left. Take it back now, y'all. Two hops this time. Two hops this time. Right foot, two stops. Left foot, two stops. Hands on your knees. Hands on your knees. Keep fucking with it. Oh, yeah. Come on. Cha-cha now, y'all. Turn it out. To the left. Take it back now, y'all. Five hops this time. Right foot, let's stop. Left foot, let's stop. Right foot again. Left foot again. Right foot, let's stop. Left foot, let's stop. Freeze! Everybody clap your hands. Come on, y'all. Check it out, y'all. Can you go? Can you go down low? All the way to the floor? How low can you go? Can you bring it to the top? Like you never, never stop? Can you bring it to the top? One hop. Right foot now. Left foot now, y'all. Cha-cha, real smooth. Turn it out. To the left. Take it back now, y'all. One hop this time. One hop this time. Reverse, reverse, slide to the left, slide to the right, reverse, 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 cha-cha now y'all, cha-cha again, cha-cha now y'all, cha-cha again, turn it out, to the left, take it back now y'all, two hops, two hops, two hops, two hops, right foot, let's stop. Left foot, let's start. Charlie Brown. Pop it out now. Slide to the right. Slide to the left. Take it back now, y'all. Cha-cha now, y'all. Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Do that stuff. Do it.
Thank you.
So she has no say in it. May her soul rest in peace. I am blessed with all these beautiful nieces and nephews and grandnephews, one who stole my heart right here. I thank the bride for choosing me to make this toast. I just want to say that I hope that the love for each other will make you feel protected, but not smothered. Challenged, but not controlled. Wanted, but not possessed. This is your first day of your new life. Everything that happened before today is obsolete. I hope that you will let the Lord lead you in all your endeavors. And as the Bible says in Ephesians chapter 4, verse 26, don't let the sun go down in your wrath. Be angry, but sin not. Always kiss and make up. And if you have to rush out in the morning, somebody will call you and say, I just call to say, I love you. foundation that will make a good marriage. I pray that the Lord will seal this union and you will live a long and healthy life together. God bless you, Milton Carmen. I love you.
Thank you. Congratulations to Mr. and Mrs. Claire. Let's look to the Lord in prayer. It is indeed a joyous occasion. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your grace and your mercy. Lord, we thank you, Lord, that for the blessings of families, Lord. We thank you for the gift of marriage, love, oh God. Thank you for this divine connection between Mr. Milton and our dear beloved Sister Carmen. Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus that you'll continue to bless them as they start this brand new journey. Lord, I pray, we pray now for the cake. We commit it to you. Lord, it's a symbol of unity. And so as partakers, as we are here as friends and family, Lord, celebrating, may it bring nourishment to our bodies in Jesus' name.
Amen. Great pleasure to be here. I'm honored. I feel honored to do this for my cousin. Hope God bless and give them peace in everything that they do. God bless you all. Tonight. Thank you.
And I just wanted to say I'm glad my aunt and Bill found each other. I could see they truly love each other. And blessings and more life to you. Wishing you all the best. Okay? My name is Adir. And this is my, I don't know anyone here knows my name. I'm a friend of him, Auntie Carmen, for many years now. I met her on a case in Stewart, and it was a blessing when I met her. She's the same person from 2007 until this moment. And Auntie Carmen, I love you from my heart, and I wish you all the best. And Mr. Claire, I want you to take care of this lady. Not from the outer part of her, but from the inner part of her. She's an amazing woman. And I love her as a mother, as a friend, as everything. And I wish everyone to raise their glass and give Auntie Carmen a toast. Cheers. Cheers.
Congratulations to my loving cousin. And Mr. Milton, let me tell you, my cousin is one of the best of the best of the best of the best. You didn't make a mistake tonight, Mr. Milton. I can assure you, you have done the best thing life could ever give to you. She is a gift from God and God alone. So please take care of my loving cousin and do not hurt her, because if you hurt her, you hurt me too. She is my loving cousin. Congrats, congrats, congrats. Please take your glass as we do the chairs.
Well, Milton, you was one, you know. There's nothing your big sister can do for you. So you got to take care of her. Miss Carmen, on behalf of me and Milton, you have a good husband. You get one. He was a dame for you. You know. You know, me and Milton, we talk, and he really, really, really love you. Guys, he love her. So please, give him a chance, okay?
I told him, me and Claudia, now, but I call it the Milton, yeah? Oh, brother, left everything and drop everything because of you. Find a pearl, and you stick to her, yeah? Just like that. Me and you are the same date as the terror, brother, yeah? So we're good. We're good.
Welcome to the club. Welcome to the family. When I was getting married, you was the man who come and put up the tent. So here we are. Big up. Love, love. Long life. Take care of your wife. Wife, take care of your own man.
I am Michelle, the daughter who Carmen has never birthed. Always going to be Wish, always going to be the oldest child to her. I just want to say congratulations to you both and wish you all the best.
I thank you.
And the nephews.
I'm representing for them tonight because everybody's good to come, yeah? Anyway, Auntie, I love you. Not just me. We all love you.
Yes!
Woo-hoo! Mama D is not here, but you is like the other Adisi that keep the family together.
Yes.
You glue us together.
Yes.
No matter what, you're the one, you call everybody, what's going on? And we love you for that.
Yes.
You have a beautiful heart.
Yes.
You are definitely a child of God. As the lady had said earlier, you did not make any mistake. Milton, when you're married to this beautiful lady tonight. We're not just talking on behalf of her only. We're letting you know. And you don't mess with her. You don't mess with her. We get you, okay?
We coming.
And we all wish you guys the best. Happiness, success, good health, and strength.
Amen.
In Jesus, all right?
Auntie Carmen, Mama D is not here, but I love you. And wish you a Merry Christmas. And all the best.
I am Milton's oldest nephew. I'm technically his first son. I want to say congratulations to the bride and the groom and wish you all the best. May the Lord continue to bless and keep you.
His big cousin that used to bend his finger when he was little. He was always so, he was special, he was so nice. So tonight I stand here to say congratulations to both of you.
I like you. I really like you.
Thank you. I pray that you guys will have a beautiful and long life together. And may the Lord bless you both. May the Lord guide you both.
Hallelujah.
And may the angels take charge of this marriage.
Amen.
God bless you both.
Good night, everyone. Last but not least, by the way, I'm Doreen, otherwise Navlet, as Carmen's bigger sister. She always act like she's the biggest one. I just stay behind her and she direct the way. And she's the glue to the family. And she's the more talkative, operational, and everything first. I just wish her today, her special day, the union together. I hope you guys may live in prosperity, long life, and lots of love for each other. Milt, we love you. Yeah. So don't forget about it. I have your back. And my sister, I love you endlessly.
Oh, yes.
Endlessly. So this is my art, and my children is my art. So I just want to thank everyone that's here tonight, and may God bless you on your journey.
Hello, everyone. Good night. I'm Christina. This is my mom that's getting married, and now my stepdad, I guess. my mom always told us that she waited until we growed up so that she could find a man, that so nothing could happen to us, and that she made sure that we were okay. So I just really appreciate that. And I mean, now I see that she's happy and she found the one that she wants to be with, and her companion, and so this makes me glad to see that she was able to do that and not miss this opportunity. So I thank you guys, and I love you guys, and I hope you guys have a very long and prosperous marriage. And
yes. I'm a little bit shy, but as to speak, love my auntie so much. So much. But I see my respect. I have the best wife in the whole entire world. So just keep it real. My auntie, love her badly. My auntie, maybe take a light over and I can stick there.
Can I say one thing? Remember, Mel, when you marry a woman who has been living by herself all these years, do everything on her own, please
compromise with her, because she will still continue to believe that she's single. But just whisper in her ear, babes, remember I'm your husband. just remind her, because we tend to forget when we live alone and make all the decisions by ourselves. Talking facts. We make all the decisions by ourselves. So sometimes we forget that now we are not alone. We have somebody to confer with, to make the decision together. Okay? You know I love you.
Well, what I'm going to say now, in marriage, is not all about one person, it's all about a partnership. And believe me when I tell you, say, it takes two hands to clap, not only one. So whenever you think about this thing, just remember, it takes two.
Sister Carmen, and I'm so happy to see her. Not the first time, Carmen, about a few times I see Mel. My God. Mel, tell me if I have your car. So I call him and see me. Carmen, I met him. I said, Mel, I said, Carmen, I cannot marry to Mel. You know, I said, Mel, a good man. Take Mel and marry to him. I see that. See two of them there. And Mel and Carmen married. And I tell Carmen, say, Carmen, take Mel and marry to Mel. Mel is a good man and see that. Thank God. I love you. Mel, you know, me love your family.
So, take the time to say congratulations to the bride and the groom, and this is an honorable thing.
Yes, it is.
The word said marriage is honorable, and the bed is undefiled.
Amen.
And this is the only time that we defy man, where 1 + 1 is no longer 2, but 1 + 1 is equal 1.
That's right.
And so there is this oneness here that I just ask that you guys will continue to share your love, continue to listen to each other, continue to always be caring and concerning with one another. And I just want to say to my brother over there, he knows that, you know, you have to stay the course no matter what. Life is very, very important, and marriage is a lovely thing, but you have to work your way through. This is the only thing that never comes with a manual, and so you have to devise your manual as you go along. I speak from experience. I've been married to his cousin for 40 years. And you got to go ahead with the manual. You got to work your way through. You got to keep loving. You got to keep giving. You got to keep smiling. You got to keep respecting. You got to keep knowing that those who love you will not seek to disappoint you. So keep loving. Keep giving. Keep understanding. Keep honoring. And remember, the best is yet.
Here. Good evening, everybody. Yeah, there we go. The wake up now. Yeah. So, in honor of my mother, in case y'all don't know, I'm the first. Should have been the final, but I'm still good. But congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. Clear. It's been an honor to get to know this guy since he came in the family. He's been doing wonderful things, and I want to continue. Oh, let me put on the mic. I want to continue with him doing what he's been doing. He's been honorable. He's been generous. He's been humble. And trust me, you have to be humble in this family. Yes. Because we got a great lead, some great females. Yeah, we got some great females in this family. And this man came in, say so inherit something great. Okay? So every time you go out of your bed, remember that. When you wake up in the morning, remember that. Just know you know what me come look for you after that. But to my mother, it's glad from the fullest of my heart, the fullness of my heart, to finally see that you settled back down, you're married now, and now you can take it easy. You're two owner now. What they say, once marriage is two become Man. Oh, me know me, that's my name. Thank
you.
So, it is an honor to welcome you to this family. Your family is now our family. Our family is now your family. We love in here. And that's it. We love in here. So no matter what, you can always come and talk, counsel, whatever you need. Uncle Sabli, you're 97. 97. Don't give him no more. 97.
Anything is
so. Thank you, Auntie. So, if you need elder advice, it's here. Anything you need is in the family, but most of all, we give love. You understand? So, welcome. Thank you. And I want you to keep that smile on my mother.
Thank you.
I just want to respond and say thank you. My husband is not really a talker, although he have to respond. But I just want to say to everyone here, I really appreciate you guys coming in to make this evening so special. Without you, the guests, dressing up all so nice, we couldn't have this special moment. So I just want to say thank you, thank you, thank you. I appreciate it. And the ones that are traveling so far, and you know, I know people come from afar, and so I just ask God blessing and safety to take you guys to the destiny I have to your destiny nation. I have my nephew from New York and his wife and son. I want to thank him for taking the time out. I know you have to get to work back tomorrow to be here celebrating this time with us and all. Milt family, you guys are special and friends. I want to say thank you. Thank you. You're the God one of them over the years that been training him, that have been loving him, that have been doing all the things that God allow you to do so that I have him as a husband, a good guy. I want to really, really thank you, family, you know, and God bless you. And I want to also thank my family too that accept him from the first time they meet. He really not a lovable guy. But I really want to thank my family for, you know, opening their heart for him from the beginning. And that's why we have this special day today. And, you know, I just want to thank everybody. And just continue to pray, hope, and pray for him. You know, that his life will go to the direction that God wants him to be. You know, as I love that song I sing in church today, that in your hand I place today, tomorrow. In your hands I surrender all. That's what we wanted to do, to place our hands in God's hands and surrender all to him. So I really, really thank you guys and appreciate you. You make my, I'm very, very blessed tonight. And the reason why I'm so blessed, and everybody was saying so beautiful, but tonight, this morning early as I was in the hotel, and still struggling through this after being a local, I mean, for so many years, single. And this morning I get a really blessing. My friend Roberta was there, it's like heaven open and give the approval for this wedding. And that was so special for me. So I am very happy and comfortable tonight because I even appreciate, even already bless us and accept it. So I really thank you. And I want to say that thank my nephew Larry and Sherfa because as you guys all know, why I request all white, it was a all white party for my niece and nephew that I met Milt. So being in all white, and I want to say also maybe that you guys we were a hot couple, not a real couple. We were a hot couple according to my church belief. But I don't know, God already maybe have it planned out for it to be like that. Because at the night when we were at the party, maybe you guys, I shouldn't share this with you guys. I remember I was here and I have a date there that night. And we were leaning up on your fence here, Larry and Sheriff. And it was so boring and whatever with him there. Right? I didn't know what to say to him. So I said to him instantly that, you know what? They're serving dinner. I'm going to go get some. Can I get something for you? I was saying to my friend there. And he said, no. And I said, okay, I'm going to get something. And here I walked off. And I bumped in this guy. Been talked to like that before, and I remember as I'm bumping him, he turned around and said, "You know I want you." Just like that. And I said, "Give me your number," and he walked away, and I thought I'd get rid of him. And then little from the old, here comes with the phone, "Put your number in my phone." That was a mistake I did. Because this is not natural thing. I should not put his number. Not a mistake. And I don't know why I put the number, my number in his phone. And then shortly after, 10 minutes after, so he keep calling me, bothering me. And that's it. And you know, many times through the journey, I met Meltam, we separated, and you know what happened? Somehow we end up to turn right around in a circle and facing back each other. Amen. And I don't know why, and there we start again. But I think God has his hand into this. And I remember what he says to me when I said, "Are you available?" I said, "Yes, but no." But I wasn't interested. And he said, "You know what happens? Even if it takes me 5 years, I'm going to wait for you." Well, it takes about 3.5 years. It didn't take him 5 years. That's some reason God have cut it short. But that was the beginning of our journey. And I just want to thank God and thank you all for making this evening so, so special tonight. God bless you, and you guys have a safe journey back.
Friends and families and everyone. Ken, love you. Best landlord we ever have. Believe me.
Yeah. You deserve a crowd. Yeah.
Best landlord. Big up, Ken. Big, good. All right. Real. All right. I'm not a good speaker or spokesperson, but it's all about this. It's Yogi. Yogi, where are they? Yogi!
Why you here, son?
Alright, you know, I don't think I'm going to talk until I see Yogi come right there. So, Yogi! Can you give me the strength? Jenko people, I want to listen to my issue now. Alright, it goes like this. One morning, I wake up and I told Yogi that, you know, that I'm going to marry your mother. He said to me, "Well, I heard, but I never heard from her, and I never heard from you, but I heard from someone, people out on the street." I said, "Well, if your mother never tell you, understand, I never really have the reason to tell, because I was expecting her to tell you first." Mm-hmm. But at the same time, over there talking, cut the story short.
Yes.
He said to me, "Mills, congratulations, because you know what? I was talking to one of my friends the other day, and you were there, and I was saying to my friend, I'm here with my mother boyfriend, which I don't really like to say. You understand?"
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying. He said, "Mills, congratulations. Know that you're going to be my mother, husband. I can't proud to tell anybody, my mother, when I'm talking to anybody, and you're here with me."
Mm-hmm.
Ken said, "I'm here with my mother, husband. I don't like to use the word my mother, boyfriend."
Yeah. Yeah, so.
So, when he said that to me, I said, "Well, I never say anything to him. But on my way going to work that morning, I was getting ready to go to work. But on my way going to work, talking to myself." Yeah, I was talking to myself. I said, "Well, I really see that this family is with me. You understand? I really see that I have a good stepson. You understand? And so far,
I see that I really have a good stepdaughter, Christina. Yeah? She do a lot of things where I can say, well, I love her as a stepdaughter. You understand? And so it's three of them, Dean, Yuan, and Christina. And all of them show me respect and love. And I hope I can, I really hope.
You can do it.
Yes, you'll get for real. I hope and I really hope, really hope. Listen, I hope if I really can do it, but I know I'm trying.
Yeah. Yeah,
nobody's perfect. Nobody's perfect. Understand? And I try my best. I'm trying my best to do the best I can because I love my wife.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hallelujah.
That's it. You just did it.